Alright guys, hello everyone, this is Space Kasian, and welcome to the Star Wars Reaction Time. But today is Thursday, so if you want an hour to watching Star Wars videos, but let me know, and I'll be sure. Because today, we're going to see the Star Wars stuff. So, without further ado, let me introduce these. But anyways, let's begin with these Star Wars videos. And action!
Oh boy.
It's the Pizza Head Show!
The Pizza Head Show!
Hey everybody! My I just saw the Star Wars movie in the theater! Man, that was hey, what's that?
The Death Star is targeting us, Pizza Head, and Princess Steva says you're
okay. Well, that's Megabyte, and with that different voice there.
And he says you'll be okay as long as you use the force.
I'll rest your body, Sean.
We're going to space!
Hey, we're going on to space. My name is Sean, and I'm the alien Robodummy.
And me, the Aryan. But you're gonna need to get Star Wars on this time. It's Darth Vader!
Well, we're going back. But you'll need a pass.
See you next time. I think the Force was with me. Now you
Mega
can collect one of the Star Wars posters when you get
to the kids back. Noting armies. Am I gonna need a new
hey guys,
one?
It's Rey. Just kidding.
And I'm Amber.
Welcome to another Nerdy Nubbies.
Nerdy Nubbies recipe!
For kids! I got so many requests from you guys to make some Star Wars.
Did I ever do Star Wars for the portion bread?
I know that you should have put some portion bread. It looked great. I thought, let's make this into a recipe. What would be the most similar? And I thought, mug cakes. Because in the movie, she just adds water.
Ta-da! It's mug cakes. Mug cakes. You gotta need a good old recipe.
If you guys remember,
well,
I made three of my favorite
sure
mug
like
cake
recipe,
recipes
though.
A while
and
back.
Good morning! And today is
so today
the first part.
Today we are going to be making a matcha mug cake. Let's get started.
Well, I just need
to make
cereal.
A portion mug cake will be 5 tablespoons of self-rising flour, 1 egg at room temperature, 2 tablespoons of coconut oil, 3 tablespoons of sugar, 1 tablespoon of matcha powder, 2 tablespoons of milk, and a pinch of salt. You'll also need some ramekins or 1 coffee mug. I absolutely love mug cake recipies because they only take about a minute to make.
So you never heard of that
one?
But here's the thing to do.
Bowl, self-rising flour, sugar, matcha
not
butter,
that there
and
much time to go to the mall.
If you love green tea, you may love this
what?
Cake.
I don't like green tea, I really but it's a few hours.
Now in a small bowl, mix together coconut oil, 1 egg, and milk. Whisk together until well combined. You guys, this is almost ready to cook in the microwave. I told you this was super easy. Now combine your wet ingredients with your dry ingredients. Our matcha cake powder is ready. Here's the part where you either pour it into a large coffee mug or 2 small ramekins, whatever you'd like. I'm going to do 2 small ramekins.
Well, nice to meet you.
Kaba,
my name is Galaxy.
With my friend
BB. And it's a long galaxy far, far away.
In the microwave, so fill them about 2/3 full. Our little matcha cakes are ready to cook. Pop them in the microwave for 1 minute and 30 seconds. I'm going to be cooking mine 1 at a time.
Well, it didn't mean to communicate. So it's W4NN. And my name is Shiny Scarfish. So shiny, so shiny.
And look how cute. It looks
looking cuteable.
Aw, cute baby
Nate.
I think it's gonna look like a droid.
We're now watching the Penny Shop product.
Yeah, Penny Shop.
Star Wars Kenner.
Wait a minute. What did they say? Hey there. It's Lucky Penny Shop in some crazy way, but today.
Hey, it's a Lucky Penny Shop Star Wars. But it's 1:40 in a lock and pieces of the puzzle.
Wow.
But you are gonna love this, Puzzle Lovers. But still got the morning stuff. And mine? Well, my name's Froggy the Rugged Isle. By looking after that puzzle anyway.
Hello, I'm Taplashi, and I'm just an alien as Splashy in here. Nice to meet you, Taplashi. But look at that!
That's a little great in its gratitude.
Than what the box says, but you'll see it on the listing on eBay. It's still there, folks. It's not there.
It's not there.
Maybe we
have other cool puzzles. Hey, it's all Luna. Pieces. Hello, Luna. Why, it's a good one of puzzle pieces to go together.
It's a Star Wars jigsaw puzzle. Very cool scene on there.
Here's the next one. It's the C-3PO.
Now watching a Lucky Penny Shop product feature. Hey, it's Lucky Penny Shop, and we have a C-3PO.
Ooh,
and look at
that's Droid. That's C-3PO, all now right. But still got the quicks the of that episode. But you are didn't do anything.
Hold on. Hold it. Hold it. You can't do the Valentine's Day figure. But actually, this is Star Wars Day, not just old Valentine's Day for traditions.
Well, I'm okay. Am I gonna be here sometimes?
Well, sure. Everything's just the grand review.
Ooh.
You are a droid.
You are so strange. And I'm going to need a rocket ship.
Hey, you didn't know my name is Lunchbox.
I would say this 12 inches.
Is there a rocket in space?
Pretty neat, huh?
Yep, we're all the rockets.
How often do we get these in our possessions? When we do, we like to show them. Come on, Candy. Focus in. There you go.
Yep.
Well, that's it. Hey, we do it.
Hey guys, it's Ro. Welcome to another Nerdy Nummies. Valentine's Day is right around the corner. It's less than 2 weeks away. And I have a lot of people in my life who love
Not about Valentine's Day either, but it's Star Wars Day.
Or that special someone. Today we're going to be making our chocolates.
It's time to get the Star Wars Day, but not literally Valentine's. Wow, that's too bad.
Hey, then how do you say you're going to need a fairy problem? My name is Barry, and I'm Ewok of Splashy.
Nice to meet you, Barry. But in the meantime, it's R2-D2. Yep, sounds like a little bit of joy.
Well, there it is. Seems a little bit different, though. You're going to need to get glue sticks on my meat.
Today, I'm going to be making two different types of chocolate candy, starting off with white chocolate macadamia nut.
Oh, it's R2-D2, all right.
I love white chocolate macadamia nut cookies. So good. All right, so the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to take some macadamia nuts and crush them up. You can do this any way you like, but this is what I like to do. Take a little Ziploc baggie.
Hey, do I need to get a superstar now? But seriously, we're heading off.
And then take a rolling pin and crush them up.
Crush them up.
Ready to nom on. Also, a side note, the macadamia nuts that I'm using have sea salt on them, and I really like that because I like
macadamia.
The next thing we're going to do is melt our white chocolate. I heated mine up in the
Since the before the walk, but you knew it. Yep. Nope, it's 7:21. Got some few more minutes.
Okay.
Has set, and you're going to add our fillings. I'm going to be adding a little bit of crushed macadamia nut. Yum, 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 yum. I just got a little spoon. Just going to place it in the middle, shake some in there. And then I've got these little caramel bites. I really like these because look how small they are. They're perfect. You can just go flop, flop. Now we're going to add the final layer, the top layer of chocolate to sandwich these little treats in. Yum, yum, yum. I also like to give it a little tap, just a little bit.
Hey. Just a little bit of top
now
of that.
We're going to put these little chocolates enough in the freezer for about 10 minutes to set. And while they are setting, we're going to do some arts and crafts.
Ooh, man.
We are going to be making some decorations. The first thing I'm going to do is I want some R2D2s from the template I made. Just take your scissors. And I made sure to print it on a thick
piece. What do you mean it serves to the work? Did I? It's like a quickie one. Did I?
Take off the lid of whatever chocolate box.
Did I?
You're going
to
place it face down on top.
That's R2D2. Inside of the box.
One of them, a ton of different colors. You can make them whatever color you want. You're going to take your pencil, trace the shape through the heart all the way around. Now, you're going to take your scissors and cut it out.
Dun, dun, dun.
Is it arts and crafts time? Or is it hearts and crafts time? Now the next thing that we are going to do, we are going to cut a smaller heart to fit on the inside of our red heart. In the past,
I think it's 3:53 p.m.
And I had another.
You can't wait till they're missing, though.
And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the lid off.
Sweethearts, huh?
I'm gonna use this as a stencil. And again, take your pencil.
Am I going to be a sweetheart? But who cares about it anyway?
Now that we've got our cutout and our little R2D2, we are going to put our little R2D2 onto the
R2D2.
Blue heart.
That sounds really nice to me.
Find the blue on the back of the little R2D2. Then I'm just going to lightly place some near the bottom of the heart. We've got little R2 glued on there. And now we are going to write a personalized message. There are so many cute things that you can write.
No, that's not just Rowlett. She's a bird.
You could write, you
I think she is a bird, but I'm not a bee, though.
Or, you are the droid I'm looking for.
I'm looking for the droid.
You're
there.
You're the only one for you.
Alright, now we're going to glue this on the top of the box. Boom. There you have it. Now we're going to put this out of the freezer.
Let's make it.
Just took our R2 chocolates out of the freezer, and now we're going to pop them
out. Well, if the Valentine's not, you are having a Star Wars Day tradition.
Because 8 little candies fit in this little box. Over here is my chocolate box, and I've lined it with a little cupcake liners and 8 thin and perfectly. I really like these molds. You can get them rubberies. You can pull them apart and stretch them to get your candies out.
I think I'm in a cake. W4NN. You're supposed to do something.
Here are the R2D2 chocolates.
What's a galaxy? Mighty a galaxy shark. Be with you. I don't want the shade, though.
And you can customize them to whatever flavor.
Next!
The Feast of Fiction Star Wars Bantam Milk.
We've been having requests for blue milk from Aunt Beru and Uncle Owen for the longest time from Star Wars Episode 4. So we finally decided we're going to make it, but we're going to add in a modern twist.
Now, of course, it's the modern twist, baby!
And we also don't have blue milk that exists in this world.
Well, I think you'll need blue milk, but it looks really good. And now, like, pour cookies!
There distances of the galaxy very far, far away.
Wow. Yeah. I'm a pork.
I guess I should start watching.
Oh, really? Her name is Winga.
Let's start.
Hello, Winga.
The bantha milk that Luke drinks in Star Wars before may have just been colored blue for the sci-fi
effect when
they first filmed it, but we'd like to think there's a real reason for the strange color.
I know the milk's color blue, but she's cosmic.
Like red cabbage, then it would make a lot of sense. So let's get to the recipe.
She's cosmic.
In order to make natural blue food coloring, we will be extracting it from organic sources. In this case, red cabbage. Cut up your cabbage and then place it into a pot. Heat up your pot on medium high and fill with water until the cabbage is fully immersed. Let this boil for 20 minutes or so, then strain the liquid out of the mixture. Because food colors are very concentrated in nature, we're going to need to reduce the liquid we need. So pour this back into the pot and continue to simmer and carefully monitor it so that the liquid does not burn. Once the liquid is reduced, we're going to complete the chemical reaction that we theorize might have happened in the bantha's stomach. Mix in a small amount of baking powder and watch the magic happen. The liquid will turn blue with the chemical reaction, and you've successfully made natural blue food color. Now let's make our thick bantha milkshake by
adding some bananas, yogurt, what are you talking about?
Blend this all together until it is a smooth liquid. Pour in some of your natural food coloring and keep blending until your milk is the right color. Set this aside in the refrigerator.
Using
some
puree
crust, download our pork cutout and line it up over the bread. Carefully trace and cut out the shape using a knife and continue until you've cut out as many as you can. Brush them with butter and coconut flavor.
Is he a shark or an alien?
10 minutes until they're browned. And take them out and let them cool. To paint these, mix brown food coloring with a couple drops of vodka and stir. Liquefy it and allow it to dry.
Yes.
You can also use
it.
All that's left is to use a brush to carefully paint on the pork to little wings and patterns, then use a black food ink marker to
paint
the mouth, nose, and eyes. Pour the milk into the glasses,
that looks like
set the cookies
a
aside,
it looks
voila,
like the same species
the
as pork.
Blue milk from Star Wars Episode 4 in a cute assortment.
Well, he's not just a little bit of hamster,
this
though.
This is the perfect companion
it's a bird.
To dip into this healthy animal.
It's a...
It was a ton
it's
of
a
fun using natural food coloring.
So,
even though we are limited to the colors we can make, blue was a great companion for our milk. We're super excited for the next Star Wars movie, and we hope
Yippee!
You are too. Ooh, look at this.
Charles.
Natural, too. We've used a lot of food coloring on the show.
Mm-hmm. And food coloring games, the next level.
Mm. Hey,
wow.
Your games
yes.
are going to be next level. I think I need to come in too.
Me too.
Gonna need to come different.
Oh my gosh.
Mm-hmm. The coconut apple
is
the banana.
I think
mm-hmm.
they're
nice.
Really amazing.
So
and they're delicious.
They're so cute.
Very sweet. Delicious.
Pop quiz.
What?
What's your favorite Star Wars movie?
I haven't seen
it. I think I never heard that one too.
Pop quiz, Ash. Who is Darth Vader?
Darth Vader?
I am your father.
All right. Okay. Some things have made it across the culture divide.
I am your
yes.
father.
All right, Ash. What sound does a lightsaber make? Yeah.
Can you make me have a lightsaber in post?
Too lazy.
Ew, too languagey.
Maybe if this show ever gets a real budget, you can be like, I want an X-Wing here.
I'll take a lightsaber right now. Boom.
Yeah, I want this there, a lightsaber.
Ooh,
here.
Lightsabers.
Just like that.
What kind of noise does Ashley make when something appears in post?
Boof.
Poof.
I appreciate how healthy it is right now, especially.
It's true.
Well, that's true.
Right.
But suddenly happens.
Him? Oh, it's a
I think I
Maybe
never die.
Reveal about him tonight.
He's a good actor.
I'm talking about these guys.
He's a good actor.
Ooh. No!
All right, it's that time again. That's right. We are still giving tons
You're bringing those
skeptics
for the super Nintendo
yes.
stuff.
We'll be back to the community, you guys. So, yes. Power A and Turtle Beach.
Nobody worries about that.
What's
you?
Sick swag and
excuse me. My name's Troggy the Troggador.
Just look at the comments. We're going to be detailing exactly how to enter as well as on our Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. So if you want more chances to win, guess what? You got to follow all of those platforms if you have accounts.
And you got to follow all of us.
Yes, actually, that's very true. Are you doing any...
You are now watching a Lucky Penny Shop.
Oh, Lucky Penny Shop!
Hey there!
Here's another one!
Penny Shop, and it's Star Wars R2-D2 playset.
And that will be the last one.
Up here to
it's
top right
Star Wars Jigsaw
Puzzles. 4085/23999ASST.
Da 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 da
Have you ever seen Star Wars? You're gonna love that one. But it's a machine for R2-D2.
And while I have this in my hand, this is actually the piece to make your own lightsaber, see?
Well...
sections here. Has three different figures there. We made one of those so you can check that.
Hey, you're gonna need to keep playing.
What? The top of
seriously? There need to keep Play-Doh. Playing on that
pretty neat.
Play-Doh.
Now, this is also a storage container, so when you're done, you put all your pieces in there and you can store them like that.
Oh.
What else do we have? Nice little cutter, so I can cut this piece here. Look at that. Nice.
Excellent.
Knife. Pretty neat. Pretty neat. Let's cut. Let's cut. So here's the mold we actually have. Now they tell you on the back, look, it's Anakin, see? The Anakin mold. It's stamp C-3PO, Oshaka, and Obi-Wan Kenobi. And
well, seriously,
Star Wars shapes, because when you lift his head off,
that's smart, huh?
There's more shapes up here than you can do on top. There you go.
No need to worry, panic.
I think I need to set
the playset. But it's coming out 2009.
The Play-Doh and it's from Hasbro. We had to add this because
Hasbro.
And there's also a pair of scissors.
Whoosh. Wow! Lightsaber time!
Pretty cool lightsaber sound.
Wow!
Well, thanks for checking it.
Okay.
You are now watching a Lucky Penny Shop.
Here's the last one.
Hey, it's Lucky Penny Shop, and here is.
Oh, you stick it out for part two, huh?
We have 200 piece puzzles.
But even the last video for part one. But we're going on the next part. Part two. That's right.
Hey, you're gonna need to seek through these puzzles.
Wow.
That's new.
48 count Star Wars puzzle. This is a standard puzzle. Clone Wars.
Ooh, jigsaw puzzles. Many never heard of play.
Let me stand that on back up. And one more in the back. And we haven't even opened these.
Let's see if I can. Puzzles, huh?
Puzzles. Let me show you those.
You're going to need to figure it out.
It's just a piece of the
piece by piece by piece.
Highway trickery, man. Highway trickery. See? All right, let's see what this
puzzle
looks
like. Okay, you're going to need to spare me. Uh-oh.
Cool, one more. Pretty neat. So if you're into puzzles, we have a lot of them. Videos, all kinds, vintage, new. Here's a nice collection of Star Wars mini puzzles. Hey, thanks for watching.
See you next time, and we'll see you on part two.